I was teaching my students, and I discovered a very interesting fact, which I would like to share with you. So as I gave some problems on percentage, a student by the name of Vinita came up with this observation. Okay, and I found it really interesting. So the question was somewhat like this: a 24% of, say, 50. And she said that, well, she found this very difficult, so she said that should be equal to 50% of 24. And I thought, well, I'm not sure. Let's check that out. Okay. 24% of 50 is same as 50% of 24. So let's do this first. How would you find 24% without a calculator? So, well, to find 24% of 50, I always like to find 10% and 1%. And if you know 10% and 1%, you can find any percent. So 10% is 1/10. So 10% of 50 is 5 or 5. Okay, so 1% should be how much? Should be again 1/10 of this, which is 0.5. Which is 0.5. Okay, so if 10% is 5, how much is 20%? Well, that's easy. That's double of 10%, which is 5, so that should be 10. And so from 1%, you can find 2%. You're just doubling it. So 2%, if 1% is 0.5, double of 0.5 is 1. And from that, you can find 4%. So again, double of 1, which is 2. So I'll write now the 4% here. 4% of 50 is 2. So you can add these two. So, well, you can say 24% is 12. That is easy. But now let's check it out whether. So let me scroll this up slightly. So what you found was 50% of 24. 50% of 24. Well, 50% of 24 is very easy. That's half of 24. 50% is 50 out of 100. That's 1 out of 2. So half of 24 is also 12. Is also 12. Now the next question is, can we use this for any type of problem? Well, you can try that out. Okay, so let me do it fast now. Suppose let me delete it. Okay, so let me write a question. Okay, so that it's always good to test some, and that's how people learn maths or any subject. You come up with a theory and you need to test that. Okay, so what if, say, you want to find 36% of 80. So 36% of 80. So first, well, 10% is 10% is 8. 1/10 of 80 is 8, and 1%. What is 1% of 8? Sorry, 1% of 80. If 10% is 8, 1% would be 0.8. 1% is 1/10 of 10%. So now from this you can say, well, 30% is 3 times of this, which is how much? 3 times 8 is 24. So from this you can directly find 6%. Also, let me go like this. So, okay, so if you want to find 6%, so from 1% you want to find 6%, this is 6 times of this. So 0.8 times 6. So this is, ignore the decimal point, so this is 48, and here you got one, this is one decimal place, you got 4.8. So 6% would be 4.8. Okay, so 6% we can say is 4.8. We can write 4.8 like this, and this can be written as 24.0. So we can say 36% is how much? 28.8. So let's find, say, 80% of 36. It just swap the percentage with the numbers. So 80% of 36. So let's find 50%. So okay, let's find 10%. 10% is how much? 10% is 3.6. So let me find 20%. So how much is 20%? Will be double of 3.6, which is 7.2. So we can say 30%. So 10% plus 20% is 30%. Is how much? Is this is 10.8. So 50% of 36 would be half of 36, which is 18. So let me again write. So 50% we saw is half of 36, which is 18. And then 30% we saw is 10.8. 10.8. I don't have space here, so I hope you can see. So 80% would be 18 plus 10.8 is 28.8, and it does work. So you can make up your own problem and check this out. If you go to the supermarket and you want to find, say 17% of, say, tell me, think of a number, say, of 60. Okay, 17% of 60. You check that out. That's a bit difficult, but well, you can check that out. That should be same as 60% of $17.